Finally tonight, a different kind of look at Africa through song. Jeffrey Brown talks with one of the continent's biggest stars.
Born in the West African nation of Mali, daughter of a diplomat posted around the world, Rokia Traoré and her music are a mix of African and Western influences and languages. Her musical career took off in the 1990s. She later moved back permanently to Bamako, Mali's capital, where she's lived through the troubled recent times for her country, including an Islamist insurgency that for a time led to the burning of precious manuscripts and books and banning of music in parts of the north. Traoré's new album addresses the problems of Mali and the continent, but also, as its title, Beautiful Africa, suggests much more. We talked recently in Washington, and I asked her first how she describes her music.
I would describe my music as Malian contemporary music, a mix of a profound Malian culture in which my music and, yes, my personality is rooted, and also opened to all my influences I had during my travels when I was a child.
So a mix of traditional Malian music and all that you've experienced since?
A mix, but a natural mix, because I don't try to mix things, because I want to make a mix, but I am the mix.
You are the mix. This is you, who you are.
And I simply have to do things the most natural, I mean, yes, very naturally, and it gives what my music is. And anything I do in my everyday life is also this mix, and I feel good with this mix. I feel good having different cultures around me. My band is made from people coming from Italy who stay in UK, and Malians and French people, and I like that. We speak several languages, mm-hmm. and we go from one language to another one. And my life is like that, and I like that.
In this new album, you seem very concerned to sing about Africa, its problems, and its beauty. Why do you want to sing of that?
Singing about Africa is like singing about myself. It's
like singing about yourself?
Absolutely. It's like singing about my story, and in a certain way, how I am related to this continent more than what people can think around me. Because eventually, the way I grew up, I am always considered like someone I am and not where I am. In Africa, too much European, and in Europe, still African.
So you always felt yourself sort of an outsider?
Not just a feeling, but it's something real. Yes, this album definitely, for me, it's a way to talk about my relationship with Mali, with Africa, so mm-hmm. to talk about myself.
Well, you know, on a news program like ours, we're always, when we look at Africa, it's usually reporting on the bad things, right? The wars and the poverty. You acknowledge that in your songs, but you want us to know there's something more.
Some things people see here through medias, and which gave them a very negative image of Africa, mm-hmm. is are things we live there every day. But also there are some other things which are more positive, and I don't know how to say, just a normal life and the joyful things, and just glad to be an African and living there. And it's not, when you see through Africa through developed countries' medias, it's like a continent where everybody wants to go out, mm-hmm. and nobody wants to stay there. Mm-hmm. Africans, I'm telling about Africans.
You don't recognize that Africa?
No, because it's not my case.
Well, I want to ask you about one particular song. It's Sarama. Because it is a tribute to women in Africa. And you sing, anything good I can do, I want it to be a tribute to you, speaking of women in Mali.
Oh, Mali Muso, I miss your smile. Anything good I can do, I want it to be a tribute to you.
I'm amazed by the way they are and the way they face their everyday life. They don't see themselves as victims. Uh-huh. An African woman or a Malian woman or in my village will never tell me, complain, let's say, mm-hmm. will never complain about her everyday life. She faces it and she smiles with that, and for her, it's just her life. And I admire this fact, and I it's a source of inspiration for me, really.
How do you look at what's going on in your country?
The most complicated and the very important question we were wondering about was when we will be able to manage this situation in the country in general. Mm-hmm. And I knew that as soon as everything will become normal, music will start again. And now I think there are more songs about what happened in Mali than there could be if the situation didn't happen.
Oh, really? So all of that has led to more music?
More music, of mm-hmm. course. Mm-hmm. Music is like what you think and what you feel in your deep inside. You don't find the right word to say, but you can play it and you can express it in an artistical way. You cannot stop that in a whole country and in a country like Mali.
Okay, your new album is Beautiful Africa, Rokia Traoré. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
And you can watch Rokia Traoré perform two songs from her latest album on Artbeat.